Hello and good day to all of you. So in this video lecture, we are going to cover about the solar wind and its effect on the earth. So before starting the lecture, so we have two learning outcomes of this lecture. So the first learning outcome is to learn and understand about the solar wind and what are the source of the solar wind. And the second learning outcome will cover to understand what are the causes and effect of the solar wind on our beloved earth. So before we go into the details, so we have to understand what is a solar wind. So solar wind actually is a wind which blows from the sun toward the solar system. So when we are talking about the earth, so the solar wind which is coming from the sun, it's come into the orbit of the earth and affect the magnetic field of the earth. So what are the source of the solar wind? So actually the solar wind produced because of the magnetic field of the sun. As we know that the solar wind is produced by the magnetic field of the sun. So let's understand the magnetic field of the sun first. As we know that similar to the our planet Earth have the magnetic field, sun also behave a large or the huge bar magnet with its north and the south pole. So we have the north pole here, or I think it's here, and on the other side it's south pole. But the sun magnetic field is about twice as stronger as the earth, and it's much larger, and the magnetic field of the sun can be reached toward all the solar system. And the interesting fact about the solar magnetic field is that the poles flip at the peak of solar activity cycle in every year. So the poles, like poles like north and south poles, can flip from south to north. And the sun magnetic field is very strong, as mentioned, by relating to the terrestrial standard such as Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars. But it is very complicated as well, because it keeps changing and there are some activities happening. So we are going to understand that activities, when it is happening and what are the least solar activities cycle in last centuries or throughout the sun has been came into being. So its magnetosphere, which is obviously the where the magnetic fields reaches, so the magnetosphere is actually extend well beyond to the Pluto. So it's actually the magnetic field of, or the magnetosphere is throughout the solar system. So in addition to the heat and light, the sun also emit a low density stream of charged particles. So mostly these particles are electrons and protons, which known as a solar wind. So actually when the solar winds blow, they contain, or it contain the electrons and protons, and which propagate throughout the solar system, that it can affect any planet in the solar system. And if you look at the speed of this solar wind, is actually 450 km per second. So there are many analyses have been done in spacecraft, using the spacecraft. So today we are going to discuss about the spacecraft, which is Ulysses. So which collected the data for the solar wind. So these primary mission of this space Ulysses was to orbit the sun and study its all latitudes. So we have a different latitude of the sun, So we have to study all this sun latitude. And if you more want to know about the latitude and how it's revolving, so you can refer to my previous lecture. So this spacecraft mission was actually from 1990 to 2009. And the purpose of this space Ulysses was to understand more about the solar winds and its atmosphere. So from this data, the solar wind is a stream of charged particles released from the upper atmosphere of the sun, which is called corona. And recent data from the space Ulysses shows that during the minimum of solar cycle of the solar wind emitting from the polar regions flow nearly double the rates, which I mentioned 450 km, which is almost double the rate, which is 750 km per second, than the lower latitude. So the upper latitude has the lower rate, but the higher latitude has the higher rate of the wind speed. And the comparison of the solar wind also appears to be the different in the polar regions, like North Pole and the South Pole has a different range of the solar wind. So on the right side, the figure shows actually the data or the orbit of the space Ulysses. So it was started, as mentioned, in 1990. So it's around somehow here. So you can see the data from 1999, 2000, 2001, 2002, 2003, and again it comes to here. So you can see the Earth orbit is here and the Jupiter orbit is shown in this region. But the space Ulysses orbit was in this dimension. So there are also recent activities has been doing. So the recent launch about the solar wind or study this sun, we have the launches like Wind, ACE and SOHO, which are the spacecraft will study the solar wind further. The dramatically stable vintage point directly between the Earth and Sun. And it's about 1.6 million kilometers from the Earth. Obviously, all the data which are being updated time to time can be discussed more. So let's look at the solar cycles. So what are the solar cycle? Actually, these are the some cycles in which there are some solar activities happening throughout the years or throughout the centuries. So as I mentioned, the sun output is not entirely constant, and nor it is the amount of sunspot activity. So sometimes there are large magnetic storms coming in into the solar system, but sometimes it's less. So the figure or the graph which shows from 1600 to 2050, so it's almost 450 years data. So now here you can see this actually shows the solar activities happening in the sun. So like here in this region, you can see this was a very low sun activities happening during the time of 1600 to 1700, or it can call the Maunder minimum. So this was the period where the sun activities was very low. So what it does, it actually affects all the region in the northern Europe, sometimes known as Maunder minimum. So at this time there was a very cold in the region of the Europe, so because of the low sunspot activity. But after that, after the 17th century, you can see the activities are gently changing, or it's not drastically changes. And also, there is a prediction that NASA has been predicted. So there will be a large sun activities will be happening, or the low sun activity, sorry, will be happening in 2025. So which is almost after 3 years. And also, if you look at the sun formation, so since the formation of the solar system, the sun output has been increased about 40%. But obviously, these solar activities are because of the sun magnetic field. So this keep changing. And obviously, in every 11 year, we have the change in solar activity. So you will be looking at your data. If you think from now on to back into the 11 years, so you can see there will be a drastic changes in your weather. Probably you will be feeling quite hot or quite cold during these activities. And these activities has been changing, and NASA has been working on understanding the solar wind more closely. So also there are some movies which has been released in 2002, 2006, 2009, 2012, 2016, and 2022. So these are actually based on these solar activities, which was in the time of the Maunder minimum. Now also look at the solar wind source. What is the source of solar wind? So when the solar winds started from here, so it's propagate throughout the solar system. So you can see this yellow region, which shows the solar wind, which is propagating throughout the solar system. So now we look at the effect of solar wind on the Earth. As we know that Earth also has the magnetic field, which is throughout the Earth. But obviously this can be affected with the high intense magnetic field of the sun, because as I mentioned, the magnetic field of the sun is double than the Earth magnetic field. So during the time when there is a large solar activities happening, then it can produce a high magnetic storms which comes into the region of the Earth, and it can affect on the electrical equipment on the Earth. So these solar winds or the solar magnetic fields can cause the massive space weather storm that disturb the satellite in the space and sometimes our communication system and also the power grids on the our Earth. So with that's all. I think you have learned and understand about the solar wind and what are the effects of the solar wind on the Earth. With that's all. Thank you so much and have a good day.